Welcome to our 8th edition of AD Interview. I'm Marca Sturzan from Romanian Energy Center, and this is the time when we will discuss with one representative of PADRE PIQUER School, a vocational training school with 50 years of experience. Here we have Guillermo Rodriguez Martinez, who is a technology and vocational training professor. Hi, Guillermo. I'm very glad to have you here.
Thank you, Marta, for introducing me, and thank you also for this attended meeting, because I'm very, very good to attend it.
Thank you. In this session, we will address topics like digitalization, vocational education and training, and the relationship between different stakeholders of the energy sector. So, Guillermo, diving in the topics, do you think that the vocational education and training system is currently adapting to the labor market needs and it is proving quality learning?
Yes, I think that PADRE Education has realized that digitalization on companies is happening. And it is true that this adaptation on education system has been successfully adapted, updated in some specific cases. But there is still some best training that fail to meet labor market needs and also are separate from the fast-changing world of the modern economies. But an innovation recently happened in these several years. It is also true that so many training programs at companies are more compatibility with training programs with PADRE Education. And also, I would like to add that although PADRE Education system has been neglected in the past, from recent years, it has received more attention compared to the other years, for example, in Spain. Yes.
Yeah, that's a good thing. More attention on the VAT program. So yeah, great. Guillermo, has the energy sector changed so that companies and education system must be prepared to deal with more radical changes? What's your opinion?
Yeah, my opinion of that is that it is true that there are some of the difficulties that usually come up when governments try to deal with this digitalization problem. Is that sometimes they are not capable to do radical changes in education programs so easily. So companies like in Spain, like Iberdrola or Repsol, have their own specific programs and that match with their own needs. But according to small and medium-sized enterprises, have much more difficulties to adapt to it. Also, the development of the skills and bed programs required more time to be updated, and it is also need to train teachers and educators in order to develop the whole system as education improvements.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you are right. I didn't think about the small companies that they have more difficulties in preparing their professionals. And yeah, but you are right. Further, in the context of digitalization, do you think dialogue between companies and education systems should be improved?
Yes, as teacher from PADRE Education system, as PIQUER, I have to deal with some PADRE education programs with some students, and it is known by the teachers that we need to speak much more with the companies in order to improve that integrations in the program with the labor market, because the labor market is completely changing. And we need as education system to be updated, not only in technology, but also in the tools that we give to those students in order to be competent, to be more competent students. Also, I would like to add that recently the government in Spain have planning a new PADRE education program plan, which establishes a new for, uh, a a new rewarding company's contract with the trainings, giving them much more importance to better educations. And even the government has declared that it is a priority to them to develop this better education system in order to get much more contact with the companies and with the reality that we are going through.
Yeah, this is a great news for Spain, I think.
Yes.
Guillermo, I am now shifting the subject towards you. Let me ask you about your hobbies. What are you doing when you are not working?
Yeah, I usually go running sometimes to have some training outside. But also, as a professor of technology, I would like also to treat with Arduino kits or some robotics that at home I would like to make some activities or prepare some works for the students in order to get improved, the digitalization technologies by playing with robots and programming a little bit. I think that's quite interesting, and nowadays there are so much technology camps, and also a lot of companies are even putting some money in that way to develop the minds of the future students.
Mm-hmm. You are a teacher, but you are having fun with the students, so this is a good thing.
This
you
is are, the idea, yeah.
You are two ideas, so it's very good. So, Guillermo, thank you for sharing your ideas and your opinions, and good luck with your work inside the AD project.
Okay.
So, thank you for being here.
Thank you, Marta, for this conversation, and